Yo, what is up, everybody? Jumping here, and I'm back with the new DLC for Dark Souls 2, the Crown of the Old Iron King. And I have to say, this DLC is so fucking awesome. I absolutely love it. Now, one thing I also love is reading your comments and seeing what you guys have to say. And one thing I've noticed is that you guys have pointed out a lot of different things that I did not know about or never thought of. Now, the first thing I'm going to point out is a new move that I did not think about. I never thought, you know, hey, let me go ahead and power stance this majestic greatsword or Artorias greatsword, Abyss greatsword, whatever you want to call it. I really think that you can literally call it any of those names and it would be correct. But check this out. If you power stance and then you hit L2, this is what you do. It's fucking awesome. That is an amazing animation. Now, the only thing about it, I don't know how this would work in PvP. I have a feeling that if somebody would avoid that, which it probably would be pretty easy to just get out the way, you're kind of asking to get counter-attacked. So, I don't know about that in PvP, but for PvE, it's definitely a really awesome move, and it just looks amazing. Now, the next thing I want to show, which, if you remember this sword, this is the Possessed Armor Sword. This is a sword where I had the whole big mistake with the Drakekeeper sword. It was fucking hilarious. You guys got a big kick out of that. But I felt so embarrassed because I felt so fucking stupid. But yeah, so check this out. One thing I did not think about is actually hitting L2 once again. And if you do that, you will buff the sword. So it's basically like a fire version of the Throne Watcher sword or the Throne Defender sword. Now, the final thing I want to show, let me go ahead and unequip that sword. I don't need it right now. Although, I do have a feeling I'm going to probably use it for this build. Since this is like a Pyromancer build, that is a sword I definitely want to try out in PvP. Now, the last thing I want to talk about is this ring. Now, I'm not too sure if this is true, but I have seen a lot of people bringing this up. So, I have a feeling that this might be true. And I guess you guys can tell me like what you have heard about this. But this ring is fucking awesome. Basically, this is the ring that makes it so that when you roll, you become invisible. And, you know, at first you're like, yeah, that's really cool, man. I'm like a fucking shinobi ninja. But, you know, hey, if it just makes you invisible, what's the point, right? That doesn't really make a big difference. It's not like you're gonna sneak up on somebody doing this. That doesn't make any sense. And yeah, it probably would be like a waste of a ring slot. Well, what a lot of people are saying is that this ring will up your iframes. In fact, it ups your iframes so much, it's like the original Dark Souls, where if you roll, you can basically roll through any attack. So that's freaking amazing. And if it's really true that just having the ring on will make it like, let's say Dark Souls, then you don't really have to get your ADP up anymore. You don't need agility anymore. Well, I guess you could use agility for other things, but I don't know, guys. Tell me, is that true? Because I've seen people saying that, and if that is the case, that this ring is fucking broken. That is for sure. And you're gonna see everyone using it. So I just thought I'd point that out. Alright, so there's a lot of things I have found, and I just want to show it off right here. If you jump, I noticed that if you could jump, then you can get over here. There is a lizard right here. Ah! I would say that the only way you can kill that lizard is with magic. Now, a lot of the stuff I found, I basically kind of seen it, and I was like, oh, okay. But I wanted to wait to actually record to grab the items. So let's see what this is. Bright bugs. Now, I know what these do. You could get some of these in the other DLC. It seems like all the items for the DLC are basically the same. Nothing new consumable-wise. But yeah, this new item is fucking broken. I have to be honest. Now, you know, here's the thing. You're not going to get that many of these. And that's cool. You know, it's not broken if you can only get so many. The problem is that a lot of people are probably going to cheat. Either use Mega Mule or they might duplicate the item. Like, I probably might go do that. But even if I duped this, I would probably never use it in PvP. Just because it's amazing. You inflict more damage and you receive less damage. That is a freaking crazy consumable. So, in the future, watch out, guys. You're probably going to see people using that item. And if they do, you'll know, like, what's up. It's going to become, like, the new Divine Blessing kind of deal, where a lot of people are basically just going to mule it and then fucking use it and abuse it. All right. So let's go ahead and come up here. There's a whole bunch of things I want to point out. Now, I've seen a lot of people talking about this, and I was running around trying to figure it out. I could not figure it out, although a lot of people were saying, you know, there's a fake wall. It's really hard to find. I'm like, oh, okay. But then I said, fuck it. I'm just going to look up a video, and that's what I did. That's the fake wall right there. I don't know how anyone would ever know that. This is definitely the first time they've ever put a fake wall on an elevator, which is kind of fucking crazy when you think about it. But yeah, if you come in here, there's a chest, and I know what's in here because I've watched the video. But this is a really weird item. The effect is kind of straightforward, but the item, the way it looks, I think, is fucking ridiculous. Check this out. Where is it? All right, so this is a hollow skin. It makes my head look so small. I mean, look at that. It kind of reminds me of one of those, like, voodoo heads. Shrunken heads, you know what I'm saying? It's just a really weird fucking helmet. But basically, what it does, if you want to know, it gives you 1,000 curse resist, which basically makes you immune to curse. So all those rooms, remember I was running through those certain parts and I was getting cursed over and over again. Well, if I would have had this helmet, that would have not have happened. So that kind of sucks. All right, let's go ahead and put our helmet back on. Now, one thing I did find was I found another door I can open. So let's actually go and open the door now and see what's up here. See, if you remember, I was like, man, I know there's more doors. So I wanted to just run around and try to find stuff for this video to save some time. But here we go. Here's a door. Oh, buddy. All right, so the question is, what's up here? Is it going to be an item? Is it going to be a super secret path to a boss? Who knows? Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. There's one of those things up there. Oh, my God. Okay. That is a mad warrior. Let's hurry up and buff it up. Look at this bitch. That is fucking bullshit. He was coming down here to fight me, and then he decided, I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna run to my fucking morph. Get out of that, bitch. Alright, let's use this new move. I mean, yeah, that is definitely fucking awesome. Bitch! See what I'm talking about, though? I missed, and because I missed that jump, I was basically going to get counter-attacked. And I would think that in PvP, you probably would get backstabbed. Alright, let's actually go ahead and destroy this. I know that people are saying now that these are ash idols. That's what I can basically call them. Because this whole time I've been like, you know, those fucking one things. But yeah, they're ash idols. Alright, let's come up here. Oh my god. Holy shit. Fucking die, bitch. That is ridiculous. Are you serious? There's four of these dudes? What the fuck? Die. Oh, wow. You're so smart. Oh, shit, man. This is bad. Oh, no. I gotta fucking run. No, leave me alone, dude. Oh, God. This is some trolly shit right here, man. Are you serious? Ah, no. Don't push me off. Stop attacking! Maybe it's true about this ring, because I was rolling right through their attacks. Although, I mean, the iframes in this game aren't, like, too horrible. No. Oh, God, that was close. Fucking bitch, what are you doing? Ow. All right, you want to do a jump attack? Let's do a jump attack! Yeah! What's up? Get the fuck on somewhere, dude. Yeah, that move is really fucking awesome. I really like how it knocks people on their ass. That's the thing that makes it good in PvE. Alright. Now, that's really weird that they had so many mad warriors. I wonder if they can actually drop their items. Because if they can, that actually makes a lot of sense. Alright, so this is a new room. What the fuck is up here? Let's actually check for fake walls. This is kind of strange. Oh, hey, there's a bonfire. That's cool. Alright, so this area must be kind of important. if they put a bonfire, at least I would think that this area is important. Alright, so there's no fake walls. There's something in the center, though. Let's take a look. What is this? Holy fuck, that is one big set of samurai armor. And that is a ginormous katana. I want that! I wonder if that's like a katana for a fucking giant. I don't know, let's see. Alright, so I'm assuming that we can do something with this thing. Maybe after we beat the boss, or I don't know. Maybe we have to collect all those one souls. Alright, so let's actually go to the first bonfire, because there was something else I found. I didn't grab the item, but I noticed it, and I basically investigated, and I seen that there was an item. So let's go see what that item is. Hopefully it's going to be something amazing. And I really do hope that I don't miss anything. Now, I know that there's this one dagger. I've seen a lot of people talking about that. And this freaking dagger, people are saying, is super broken. I don't know the name of it. At least I can't remember the name of it. But people are basically saying that this dagger is better. Ah, I fucked up! They're saying that this dagger is better than the shadow dagger. So, if that's the case, yeah, that dagger sounds fucking broken. And I haven't found any special dagger yet, so hopefully we will find it soon. Alright, so this is a new ring. Let's take a look at this. So far the rings have been fucking awesome. Alright, reduces stamina loss when blocking with a shield. Okay. I'm not too sure about that ring. I would probably never use it. I would say that a lot of people would probably like it, because a lot of people, well, they do like to basically run around with like a great shield and block. And if you're one of those people, that ring would probably be amazing for you. Like with me, you know, I don't really do that. Although I have been doing a little bit throughout the DLC, because this DLC has been kicking my ass. Alrighty. So, my plan for this video is to try to go and beat the Smelter Demon. If you remember, we actually fought him, got our ass kicked. But this time, I actually want to go and try to fight him again. Now, there was something else that I realized, or I found out, when I was exploring. And I need to show this to you guys so that we can actually see, like, what's up. If you remember this area is really fucking annoying. Just because, like, there's so many freaking enemies. And a lot of the enemies are kind of, like, out of your reach. Like, they're up, like, on platforms and cliffs and stuff. And there's no way for you to get over there. Well, what I realized is that if you pull this lever, that back gate will actually open. And if you don't run for it right away, then it will close. And you can't actually get... Oh, God. Oh, no! 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 And I'm dead! Super dead! Alright, let's try this again. I went ahead and I actually buffed up just to take less damage. These fireballs are annoying to get through. Leave me alone, give me my souls, thank you. And we made it. Alright, so. Oh shit. What is this new fucking spell? This has gotta be Tranquil Walk of Peace. Fucking bullshit, man. Die! Alright, let's actually investigate this area. I have a feeling that this is how you get to the top. Oh yeah. Oh shit. Oh shit. Let me alone. Give me that. Crimson Waters. I don't really care about that. Oh shit. Fuck you, dude. I'm coming to get ya. Die. Alrighty. Let's keep looking around. See what's up here. Because there's a whole bunch of shit. If I remember, up at the top. Alright, so we got another lever. Oh, uh-oh. Oh, God. Oh, I hate that shit. Fuck you. Alright, come on. Let's do our cool move. Yeah. What up? You gonna die! Yeah, you. I should probably save my potions, because if I'm gonna fight the Smelter Demon, I probably will need them. Alright, I want to keep looking around a little bit before I pull the lever. What is this about? I can drop down. I don't want to drop down. I want to pull this lever. Alright, let's take a quick look. Alright, basically, this looks like the same shit as before. Oh, there's an item in there. Well, that sucks. Because there's no way I'm going to be able to get the item and then run through the gate. Oh, shit. I probably should have buffed again just in case. Numbness is still, like, pretty freaking broken. Ah. Fuck. I just don't want to get stunned. Don't stun me! Ah! Damn it! Damn it! Oh, that sucks! Oh, man. I just got something awesome. I was fighting one of those cleric things. Ah. Bitch. Not these things, but the actual human-like clerics. And that thing dropped the Black Hollow Magehood, which is an extremely annoying item to farm. So that's, like, really awesome. I'm gonna cast Numbness because I just don't want to fucking die, man. Alright, let's do this. We just gotta basically run for it and hope we can make it. It's really all about not getting hit and stunned. There we go. It looks like we can do it. We made it, I think. Did we make it? We made it. Alright. Ah, I'm wasting my potions. Oh, shit. Hello. This is what I was talking about. Okay, that's like the Tranquil Walk of Peace thing. Ah, shit. I can't see. I don't think there's anything up here. Here, let me actually cast this. You know, this is one thing I've noticed. When you cast Numbness, if you cast Sacred Oath after the fact, the numbness actually goes away. But I was doing some testing, and it seems like you still get the defense. I mean, that's so fucking broken! Like, if that's the case. I mean, maybe that's not the case. I'm not 100%, but if you can literally get rid of the down effect, which is the blackening of your screen by just casting another body buff, that's the big problem, is the fact that you could have so many body buffs on. They can all stack together. It's outrageous. So, maybe they changed that, and I was not aware that you can no longer have multiple body buffs on at the same time. Ow, don't kill me now. That'd be horrible. Actually, go ahead and heal. Alright, I think... Oh, God! Don't kill me! I didn't even get to look what those things were. That always sucks. Alright. Let's go ahead and use an amber herb. And let's also put on our new ring. I had the ring of life protection on. Alright, so. Let's think. We're going to cast Numbness, Great Magic Barrier, and Sacred Oath. If you're wondering why I decided to put Great Magic Barrier on, is for all the fire that was coming at me slash this boss. Bitches, get on somewhere. I'm the beast. Alright, let's try this. Smelter Demon fucking 2.0. Ah, ow. Yeah, this fight is going to be fucking annoying. I can already tell you that. Ah! Itch. Wow, did my Great Magic Barrier already wear off? This is probably a really good way of testing this ring out. Because as long... If he attacks and I roll... If it's true that you can basically roll through any attack, then as long as that, like, white mist is over me, it should make me totally... Yeah, no, I don't think that's true. Well, it might be true. It's just... Might just be iframes. I don't know, like I said, you guys tell me. That's what I've just seen. I've seen people talk about it. Alright, let's go. Ugh. You know, one thing I did do, I took off my lingering Dragon Crest ring, which really does make a big difference. Oh, shit! I mean, the lingering Dragon Crest ring, it makes this huge difference in duration. It's like 50% more. That is just ridiculous. Oh! Bitch. At least I'm doing, like, a lot of fucking damage. I just wish I can buff. Come on. I need you to swing, dude. Swing! Yeah, that's what I wanted to see. Let's go! Ugh. Actually, I'm gonna buff again. Come on. Swing, motherfucker! Aha! Really, I want numbness above all else. Alright, numbness. Numb my fucking wounds! Alright, let's go. I just can't fucking see because I cast... I should have cast it first. Really, I should have actually put it on my list first. Down to two potions, so life gems after this. Let's go. Fuck, missed. Ow. See, I can't fucking see now. I know that that's the point, you know. Alright, he's gonna take like no damage. That is fucking bullshit. That is a lot of bullshit if you ask me. I mean, he can basically buff himself that much. He can buff himself that fucking much when he's only lost that much health. And now he's hitting like a fucking truck and I'm dead. Oh man, this is gonna be a pain in the ass. Oh my god, getting back is such a fucking pain in the ass. That's so bad. That is so bad. Ugh. Made it just impossible. Now I can't use my ruler sword because I lost all my souls. Can't tell, I actually went ahead and put some heavier armor on just for some extra defense. Like, I was like getting hit so hard. I was losing like about, I don't know, a third of my health in one hit as I was trying to run past those enemies if I got hit. All right, now I'm just two-handing this fucking sword. Come on. Should not have cast that. Now I am getting hit. That's not too bad. Come on, bitch, swing. Down to five potions, just from running like hell. All right, let's go. Doing okay, but that doesn't really mean much. Yeah, this guy, this smelter demon is so much stronger. Ow. He is so much freaking stronger. Oh no! What the fuck was that? Unfucking real, dude. He's blowing up. Man, this sword is so fucking strong. Where is it? Numb it up. Come on, hurry up. Ah! An asshole, so... He hit so fucking hard. I don't know what it is, but my fucking nose is... fucking killing me right now. It's like itching and I want to itch it so bad, but if I do, I'm dead. Oh, by the way, I know that I've been having some problems with the frame rate for some of these videos, these DLC videos, and that just really sucks because a lot of people, I mean, I've looked at it and I'm like, holy shit, the fucking quality is just god awful, and it's like after I die, that's what people have pointed out. But I think it's the actual editing program. I've been trying to fix it, so hopefully I was able to do it. I think I might have figured out the problem. I just went ahead and... Oh, God! Last of the potions. I could have probably actually beat this guy if... Okay, because I'm not certain if I'm going to do it now. Whoa. Don't blow up. Oh, he's blowing up. Anyway, I would have had no problem beating this guy probably if I didn't have to use up all my fucking potions to survive. Oh my god! That's just taking too long! God! Oh man, getting back here is such a pain in the ass! Go ahead and recover. Recover my zero souls, yay! Alright. I'm gonna take this real slow. I'm not gonna talk too much. I don't wanna distract myself. Ah! Come on. His pattern's pretty easy. That's the only attack I don't like so far, because that's the one that has kind of insane tracking, to be quite honest. That overhead vertical swing. Shit. I wanted to use numbness, but whatever. Whoa, see? That one. That shit has some really crazy tracking to it. That's probably the one hit that you don't want to get hit by. Wah! Actually, all these hits you just don't want to get hit by. Alright, come on, we gotta hurry. One more sacred oath, and that's it. I'm basically, to get back here, I'm... Oh, shit, that was me just asking for it. Oh, God. Okay, like, me getting back here, I'm casting all my spells because these guys just do too much fucking damage just to the normal enemies. It's hard to avoid them all when I'm getting fucking Tranquil Walk of Peace cast on me. Uh-oh, he's gonna blow up. Epic battle, man. Let's fucking go. Fuck, piece of shit, butt face. Oh shit. Come on, faster! I hate that attack. Whoa! What kind of delay was that? Oh, you fucking idiot. Okay, I need my stamina. Ooh, it's getting close. It's getting real fucking close. Just gotta keep my head. More hit should do it. And he's fucking asking for it! That is fucking right! Jump for the door! Smelter Demon Soul. Really? That's what I get? Like, who fucking wants... Oh, God! Who the fuck wants a Smelter Demon Soul? Not me. Alrighty, so that was fucking awesome. So let's go ahead and see what's up here. The Pharaoh's Mask. Alright, guys, so I know what this is. I mean, everybody's talking about it. When I was reading through the comments, there were so many people bringing it up. And once I knew what it was, I had to look it up and find out, did I miss it? You know, was it hidden somewhere? But yeah, so if you don't know what this is the Mask of the Father for Dark Souls 2. But I really don't like the way it looks. It looks like the Mask of the Grandfather, if you ask me. It's kind of ugly. And I just don't see the point of bringing this back if it's going to look like this. They should have made it look like the Mask of the Father from Dark Souls, because that would have been awesome. Now, I'm sure some people are going to use it and pretend to be a giant dad again, but there's no giant's armor, so... I don't know, guys. I really just don't like the mask all that much. I don't think it has any special effects. It's kind of a cool idea to bring it back. I thought that they would do something like this. But I think what would have been a lot cooler is to come out with the giant's armor and the mask and then just call it the armor of legends or the legendary armor. I don't know, something like that. That would have been awesome. But the way they did it, I'm not a big fan. You guys tell me what you think. But like I said, don't feel bad if you have spoiled it for me. I know I said I didn't want people spoiling stuff, but it's like impossible. I mean, people were basically just commenting saying, oh my god, Giant Dad Mask is back, blah, blah, blah. And once I seen that, I had to basically look it up and see how to get it because I knew that, you know, I didn't want to miss it. That would be one item I didn't want to miss. And I actually looked at the picture of it and I was like, what the fuck? That's ugly as shit. Alright guys, well that's going to pretty much do it for this episode. I really hope you have enjoyed it. If you have, will you please like and favorite the video for me. And be sure to subscribe if you haven't. And I really do hope that everyone has a nice day and peace out.